The Infortrend EonStor GS family product is a unified storage system that integrates file level, block level, and cloud gateway into one single system. We will introduce Infortrend Automated Storage Tiering in this video. This video will be separated into two parts. We will introduce auto tiering in the first part and demonstrate how to operate this function in the second part. What is automated storage tiering? It is a storage software management feature that dynamically moves information between different disk types and RAID levels to meet space, performance, and cost requirements. Infortrend offers an industry-leading four storage tiers technology, providing users more flexible deployment. Storage tiering is a common practice in today's IT environment. To achieve required service levels at minimum costs, businesses assign different types of data to different types of storage. Without automated tiering features, this traditional way of tiering can cause significant problems. When data characteristics change over time, users need to manually migrate data. Migrating data to other media often involves downtime and management effort. To offer a solution, automated storage tiering provides IT veterans a reliable and efficient storage deployment with outstanding performance. It constantly monitors data access frequency and intelligently dispatches the data to their appropriate storage tier. Infortrend's automated storage tiering provides an architecture that fully consolidates the advantage of different storage media, including SSDs for high performance and nearline serial attached SCSI NLSAS drives for storage capacity. With Infortrend automated storage tiering, a storage pool can be divided into tiers which feature different drive types and RAID levels. The highest tier, Tier 0, features the highest performance level, with performance gradually declining downwards lower tiers. These tier configurations can be changed by users according to their own application environment. Since automated storage tiering is done automatically, it offers a couple of user-defined tiering policies to provide the best solution for various business needs. These policies define what new data placement rules should be followed within a tiered storage pool. The first policy is higher tier first. Generally, we recommend users select higher tier first when rapid response time is the top priority. The reason is that this policy ensures the usage of high performance drives. Data are placed within the highest tier first, and users can trigger tier migration to move data between different tiers to arrange data blocks to the most suitable tier. However, users may not be able to create another tier volume within the same storage pool due to a critical issue, since the highest tier may have been occupied by the original one. To prevent such circumstances, Infortrend automated storage tiering sets a new policy by default that allocates storage space by the ratio of different drive types, such as SSDs and HDDs. The policy is called Use Selected Tiers by Ratio Calculation. By applying the policy, the system can reserve the high performance storage tier for other tier volumes within the same storage pool. Next, we will demonstrate the operation of auto tiering. We will create two storage tiers. As this function requires an additional license to use, please make sure your device is authorized to use this function. Start EonOne and open the Settings menu. Enter Storage Setup. Click Pool and press the Add Pool button. This function can only work with asymmetric active-active mode. Choose Create Storage Spaces in asymmetric active-active mode, then press Next. Next, we will start storage tiering. This demonstration will start with the creation of Tier 0. For overall system efficiency, we suggest using SSDs for tier creation. Tick SSD drives at drive selection. You can name the storage pool and select preferred RAID level here. Here we will demonstrate using RAID 1. Select Enable in the Storage Tiering pull-down menu and select 0 for the tier index. Finally, select Apply after choosing your controller assignment. Next, we will demonstrate the creation of Tier 1. Choose the storage pool you just created in Pool List, then press the Add Logical Drive button. Tick drives you want to use in Tier 1 in the Hard Drive list. Select one in the Tiering Index menu. Choose your preferred level in RAID level. Here we will use RAID 5 for example. Press the OK button after setup is complete. To verify the created tiering information, click the created storage pool and click tier information under more. Next, we will create a volume on the tiered storage pool we just created. Go to Storage Volume page. Press Add Volume. Select the created tier storage pool in the Storage Pool menu. Set the size of the drive volume here. You can use the scroll bar on the left or enter the size directly in the field. Choose your preferred transfer interface in Host LAN mapping on the bottom of the screen and press Next. You can choose a space allocation policy according to your needs in the menu. Here we will use the default Use Selected Tiers by Ratio calculation as an example. Click OK after choosing the preferred storage tier. After the volume is created, go to Volume, More, Tier Ratio Settings if you want to change tier ratio distribution. If you want to start data tiering migration, please return to Storage Pool page. Select the storage pool with created tiers, then click Tiered Migration under More. A priority order of data migration will be shown on the screen. This option will decide the system priority of data service or tiering. Priority is separated into normal, high, and low. To optimize system performance, we suggest you carry out data migration during off-peak hours. Here we will demonstrate directly using tiering migration with the priority set to high. Press Start to begin. To confirm the system's current status for tiering migration, go to Storage Pool page and click on the Created Storage Pool and choose Storage Pool Details. Progress under the Information field will show the current data migration status. You can change the order of logical drive tiering through Storage Pool, More, Tiering Setup. You can also confirm created tiering volumes through tiering information. Finally, if you want to disable automated storage tiering, you can do so by going to Storage Pool, More, Disable Storage Tiering. And this concludes our video. Thanks for watching!